Welcome back everyone to the channel. In this session I'll be covering how you can create a simple login form in your Power Canvas apps. So there could be practical scenario where you want to show some information for one set of users and possibly would like to have admins to view some different sort of information, and they can manage some information as well. So for that you would need something like a login form in the Power Canvas app. So I'll be covering that in today's demo. So I'll start with creating one Canvas app. So I'll just choose the blank layout in a phone. Okay. So as in I would like to build some background of my form. So I'll just insert one label and we'll just stretch that label so that it can fill out that screen. I'll remove the text and provide a good background color to it. So you can go to your property pane and then can provide some color. Yep, now we are good. Now for login form I'll be just dropping one label as well, which can say it's a login form. Just make it a big font size, font weight let's say bold, and align it to the center. So now we are good. Now you can see my first label got selected because it's actually overlaid on this second one. So I need to select my second label of login form and make it bring to front. So I would click on reorder and bring to front. So now this label would always be in front. The same way we can do for, we can just drag one input text which will be used to capture the username, and the same way we will be capturing one input for password. So I'll just remove the default text, and as it's a username I need to provide the hint text for it so that the user can understand it's a box which contains the username. Okay, so hint text I have typed that, and same thing I'll do for the password, and I'll type the hint text as password. Okay, now as I would like to mask the password, I would not like to have a plain text. So there's a property, if you scroll down you will find mode. In mode I'll change that property to password so that it can take the masking of the password. So we are good with these two text boxes. Now I'll just drop one button which will be a login button. So on click of this button, what I want to validate the username and password against some data source, and if the username and password does not match, I would be showing some label that you have entered a wrong password. So I just added one label, and under that label I have to change the text for it. So let's say forgot password contact admin, and can change the color for this as in red. So let's say light red. Okay. So now we are pretty much there, but we need to write or bind something with this form so that it can just validate against it. So what would that be? So let's say I would like to use my SharePoint list which will be having admin usernames and password to validate against. So I need to add that as a data source. I'll be going to view, click on data source, I'll type in SharePoint, select the SharePoint, and it will give me the list of SharePoint sites. So I'll select one of the site where my admin list is there. So I can select my admin credential list. So I'll just show you that list too, what is there. So this is my list. It's simply having the username and the passwords. So this list would be permission protected, only admin would able to see it, so that nobody can see the passwords for your Power App. So now I'm going back to my form. We have already created the UI now and added the admin credential list as a data source. Now I need to write a logic on select of this login button so that it can validate. So what I would be doing, I'll be using lookup function, which will be lookup from my SharePoint list, and the list name is admin credential. And what I would be lookup, I would be lookup where title equal to my text box 1.txt and my password equal to text input 2 dot txt. So this is how I can just compare the values from SharePoint list for these input columns, input boxes. So what this lookup would give me, defaultly it look give me the all the returned fields, so I can just fetch one of it. So let's say I'm fetching title. Now here I'll be comparing this title whether it's a blank or not, so that I can be confirmed whether that user that exists in that list or not. So I would be using one condition. So I'll type if is blank, is blank this lookup field, and comma, if it's not blank, I mean it's returning the data, so I'll append one negation sign, and if it's not blank, then it should navigate to a screen. So let's say I'll just add up one screen. I'll quickly add insert one screen, so let's say success screen. So it's a screen 2. I'll go back to my screen 1 where I'll just add up. If it's finding a non-blank field from the lookup, then it should navigate to screen 2. So we are good. If not, then what it should do, it should show my this label, this forgot password context, so it should show up that label. So I'll just say I'll update one context or a variable. Let's say it's a show forget message true. So now I have updated this formula. So it's saying if it's the lookup thing is not blank, then it should navigate to screen 2. And if it's blank, then update this variable with a context that is true. So now we are done with the app. So I'll just, and the final thing I have to do is I need to set the context for this. So I'll just go to the visibility of it, and visible, I'll set up that show forget message variable. So initially it will be false until unless if a user is entering some wrong part. I'll run it. So I'll just run with something random so that we can see whether we are getting that message or not. So okay, so we got message forget password contact admin. this is not the right combination. So I'll just write one admin and admin 123, which is the right password. I'll just log into it. Okay, now we got into the application. So on this screen you may have some form or something where you would like the admin's intervention, where they can submit or they can manage some data. So it's a subsequent screens from the from your application. So you may write your own logic to have that. So the context of entire session is to how to create a login screen and how to bind up one data source to it where it can just validate. So the data source can be CDS, can be Excel file, can be SharePoint, anything where you are keeping your username and password. So I think that's it for this session. If you like it, drop a comment and subscribe to the channel. Thank you.